They're putting the focus once again on killer negligence in Mumbai. It's happened far too often in the city. And in the latest example, during the massive dust storm that rocked Mumbai a few days ago, a billboard collapsed. This is a 120-foot massive billboard that came crashing down on people who were actually seeking shelter right behind in that fuel station. At least 14 people have died, 75 injured. Search and rescue efforts are underway. We're all keeping our fingers crossed that the death toll doesn't go up further. Now, there are serious questions being asked of the civic body of BMC that's declared that, yes, this billboard was illegal. They've issued a notice to the agency which put up the hoarding at the place. But there are serious questions about why every single time the BMC wakes up after this kind of a tragedy is reported. There are countless such incidents of an infrastructure mess of illegalities that inevitably lead to tragedies in Mumbai.
Two days after a billboard fell on a fuel station in Mumbai's Ghatkopar area and killed 14 people, the BMC is yet to act on illegal hoardings. Search and rescue efforts are underway, where the 120 by 120 feet billboard was stopped by a dust storm on Monday. Rescue teams are treading cautiously to avoid any sparks near the petrol pump. They fear people could still be trapped in the debris.
रेस्क्यू ऑपरेशन अगर हम लोग ये मलबा हटाने की बात करें, गिर्डर्स हटाने की बात करें, तो उसको बहुत और समय लगेगा, क्योंकि उसके लिए हम लोग कटिंग इक्विपमेंट यूज़ नहीं कर पा रहे. पूरी जो हम लोग फ्री फ्लो में यूज़ करते हैं वो पूरी तरीके से हम लोग यूज़ नहीं कर पा रहे. एक बार छोटी सी आग भी लग गई है तो हम लोग अभी थोड़ा सा और ज़्यादा कॉशियस है.
The BMC has promised to crack down on illegal hoardings in the city, but the agency has woken up after the disaster struck. The BMC has declared that Ghatkopar billboard is illegal and issued a notice to Ego Media, which put up the hoarding.
महापालिकेची परवानगी म्हणजे परवाना घेण्यात आलेला नाही अशा सर्व होर्डिंग वरती कार्यवाही करण्याचा निर्णय घेतलेला आहे. मुख्यमंत्र्यांनी देखील त्या पद्धतीचे आदेश दिलेले आहेत आणि ती कारवाई आज आमची सुरू होती आहे.
A case has been registered against Bhavesh Bhide, the owner of Ego Media, who's currently absconding. The BJP has mounted an attack on Shiv Sena over the illegal hoarding.
उसको होल्डिंग का कॉन्ट्रैक्ट 7/12/2021 को दिया गया. होल्डिंग बनाने थे इतने इस साइज के बनाए गए. यहाँ पर जो 14 लोगों का मृत्यु हुआ उसके लिए उद्धव ठाकरे, संजय राउत के भाई सुनील राउत जिम्मेदार है.
मुंबई महानगर पालिका में अब शिवसेना नहीं है, सत्ता बीजेपी की है. एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर बीजेपी का है 3 साल से. जो हुआ है उसके लिए जिम्मेदार बीजेपी है, किसी पार्टी का नाम नहीं लेना चाहिए.
Among those who lost lives in the Ghatkopar tragedy were petrol pump staff, an engineer and an auto rickshaw driver whose lives were tragically cut short in a matter of moments. Mumbaikars have once again paid a heavy price for the government's apathy. With Vidya and Saurav Vakhtania in Mumbai, Bureau Report, India Today.
And as in fact we asked those questions of the BMC, let's take a look at the latest as far as the rescue efforts in Ghatkopar. Saurav Vakhtania has filed this report for us.
48 hours have passed, but the rescue operation at the Ghatkopar hoarding collapse site is still going on. Here in the visuals you can see that the officials are working very hard, because let me tell you, due to the presence of petrol and diesel at this particular site, the official cannot use the gas cutter, because let me tell you, in the morning also there was a spark and some fire over here caused lot of serious problem, and therefore the official cannot use gas cutter at all. They have to manually dismantle this huge structure over here. In the visual, let me show you, ask my camera person to show you this visual. See, here they have to manually cut all this part and then take out the debris. Now what the officials have told us, that the death figure remains at 14, but the NDRF teams have also located 2 more dead bodies, but right now they cannot be removed. So if there are more survivors inside, time is running out for them. Nobody has taken the responsibility. It's just the blame game going on. Passing the bucket is right now going on. Now let me show you other visuals over here. Not just this huge hoarding, there are three more other huge hoardings over here. In the visuals you can see, this is also illegal hoardings. That is what the BMC is telling us. And right now the BMC officials are trying to dismantle those hoardings as well, and they will be pulled down. So here in the visuals you can clearly see that how the NDRF and all the rescue teams are working very much hard, because there is lot of presence of petrol and diesel inside this particular debris, and if a small spark can cause a big damage and could cause fatal as well. Let me tell you, inside this particular petrol pump, there is huge storage tank. There are two storage tanks which has almost full petrol and diesel. So there is this rescue operation is very much risky. There may be few people more trapped inside. The NDRF is saying us, and time is running out. And till now, nobody has taken the responsibility. Just BMC and the GRP are passing the bucket and blaming each other. With camera person Mandal, this is Saurabh Bakhtania in Mumbai for India Today.
And there's a need to ask serious questions here of what's led to the death of 14 innocent Indians. And this happens to so many of us that when there's a storm, you kind of take shelter in a protected area. In this case, this place of a protected area turned out to be a death trap for 14 people. And that's where we're asking the question about whether the civic agency, civic body BMC, has blood of 14 citizens on its hands, because it failed to check and curb these kind of illegal hoardings being put up in Mumbai. You saw this kind of a tragedy taking place. Why was the red flag that was raised months ago about this illegal hoarding and many others in Mumbai completely ignored by the BMC? Is this another tale of clear corruption that runs rampant in Mumbai? Three notices were issued. All three notices ignored the last few months by the BMC. The BMC failed to take any action, which is why we're questioning why the civic agency completely ignored it. Is this another incident? And I've just reported about how, you know, is this a case of corruption again? Is there also collusion of netas, of babus, and of a mafia, an ad mafia that many people in Mumbai will tell you is rampant and completely unchecked? Was BMC completely blind to this clear safety norm breach? Well, there'd be questions about how the BMC didn't know, considering, like we told you, there were three notices and nothing was done by the BMC. So clearly, knowingly, they turned the other way, refused to heed all warnings.